or when you're, as Joe Falcone will say, a native local, which there's a specific difference in some ways, your story doesn't get really told that often. And like, I know it does, but it really doesn't. And it gets quieted very quickly too. It's like, you don't talk about that. Like, don't be entitled, or don't talk about that, because, you know, the ocean's everybody's place. And that is true. I'm not saying it's not, but I also think that this conversation today would just be like that, cause a small sampling perhaps of people that are kind of from that area and are excited to be from that area and are proud, proud to be from that area and proud to kind of be part of those communities. So
it's interesting. Like, I know, like Johnny, you and I, we grew up in Long Island. I think we have like local kind of rights in certain areas, even though I feel like I bounce around a lot of different spots, but
mine extends from Rockaway to Montauk.
Yeah. Oh yeah, exactly. Right.
Yeah. Well, that's,
yeah,
I'm standing kind of. LBI.
Yeah. You know, right.
And I love Rockaway too.
But it's like, it is funny, 'cause like part of me has this torn feeling of, yeah, surfing should be for everyone, and I think it's great.
I'm not saying it's not, but let's get to it here. Yeah.
There's something there where, like, I feel like there's a tremendous amount of disrespect sometimes from people who aren't from here. They don't know who's from here. I feel like you go out in the water and there's just, I see a lot of people and I'm like, okay. And I look and I see all the newbies, the people who are the adult learners. Sorry, Chaz, right. There you go. Adult learners.
Yeah.
And you see them and you're like, oh, that's great. That's cool. I'm happy for them. But then there are people who are okay surfers. They're not bad. They can sit at the peak, but they're not from New York. They're not from here. They're not there. And then they paddle around you and they give you an attitude. And I want to be like, yo, and I feel like a dick if I were to ever say this, but I want to be like, yo, do you fucking know who I am?
No.
Like, I've been surfing here 30-plus years. My family owns one of the oldest surf shops in New York. I did all this shit. Who the fuck are you? But I don't. You know, like, I want to sometimes.
No
way.
No way.
It just sounds so stupid.
You get lit up. This is
it sounds stupid, though.
This is a good illustration. You can't do that because Stab posted the other day a photo of Joel Parkinson, right?
Yeah.
Maybe the a video of Joel Parkinson, quote, partially burning that guy, right?
Yeah.
And if you dig into those comments there, the majority of people are all saying, man, what a prick. What an entitled guy. What an a-hole. What a horrible human being.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking to myself, like, this is the guy that basically put these waves on the map, developed a whole industry, an area, infused those communities with millions of dollars, gave them pride and a world championship. I can keep going.
Yeah.
And it's like, if there's one thing that guy probably is entitled to, it would be exactly that.
Yeah.
And yet that guy is told, no, not so much. Like, let me, from my seat in Ireland, I want to tell you, you're a prick for doing that. And meanwhile, if you dig into those comments, you see the guy that does get dropped in on, as always, like, nobody likes the comment, nothing is going on there. And he says, that was me. I was way too deep. And in fact, there was a knuckle between me and the top peak. Joel's in the perfect position. As always, he should be on that wave. It's his wave.
Yeah.
And that's it. And it's like, I think so much of that, and we can go into it and all that, but it has nothing to do with etiquette. It has absolutely everything to do with, like, sociopathy. And I know that's, like, a really drastic thing to say, but it is. People are pretty – mental health is no kept secret in the United States right now, okay? There's people that are suffering from anxiety and depression and tons of other, like, psychological pathology, and that plays out in all avenues of life. Like we said, when you go to Hawaii – if you're running from something, it's going to come get you. And sadly, surfing is this great therapy. It's this incredible mindful practice that people are paying thousands of dollars for, paying professionals to help them with. And so if this does the trick, well, fuck it. I'm jumping in. I'm getting it. And there's obviously no larger consideration in that. It's the same as showing up to a basketball game at Rucker Park and saying, I'm in next right now. I'm in next. Yeah, I got my shoes. Look at these shoes. These are Kobe's reissues. I got a ball. I want next right now, immediately. And you'll get laughed at.
Yeah.
You will get laughed at. Go to the bowling alley and say, oh, we need the middle lane. And I want to set up with pins and I want a bucket of Coors Light. And they'll say, what? Who? Where? No, John's got that lane. That's their lane or whatever. So it's like, this is everywhere in life. It's just some people, when they get in the water, they just turn their blinders on and say, no, this is my day now and I'm going to take this.
Have you seen the That stab interview with Dane.
Yeah, it's great.
And he touches on that. Yeah, he says that, you know.
Well, he quotes Richie Collins from Ozone. Remember the movie Ozone?
Of course, the O'Neill.
1990. Yeah. And like Richie Collins is talking about how I'm here out working. You know, imagine someone like coming on your desk. And shitting all over your desk. Like, that's what it's like for me. I work. I surf. That's work for me. You know? And Dane was copying, was paraphrasing that in the interview.
Right. And even to the fact that, you know, he's at this ultra elite level.
Yeah.
And then you have people who just feel the need to want to flex in front of him and, you know, instead of just being like, this is, I'll segue that into a, yeah, story that juxtaposes the times between in the past and now, where people want to come flex on Dane, like where he's at. Like, have you even seen when Slater came to Jersey?
Yeah,
you know, like,
yeah, it was my hometown.
Was just like,
yeah, it's the Slater effect. And I'll tell you right now, that spot has had like so many more people at it after that, which is incredible, and it's impressive, right? Like, think about that lasting power, and no one knows that, you know. But that is a shit end of town. Literally, it's got a foul water quality. The EPA, before Christie decimated the EPA, would close that. I lifeguarded at that beach for 15 years at that exact jetty. That was like my baby of a jetty to go surf at. And it was foul, and you have to wear earplugs, and the next jetty's good too. But he came, surfed it, and after that, like for weeks, there would just be like 20 18-year-olds just ripping it, you know? And it was like waist high. Slater effect. That's incredible.
Hey, at least they're like 20, 18-year-olds. It's not like 30-year-olds on foam board.
That was 3-4 years ago. Yeah. Now it's
now
all
it's the foam board.
Foam board. Yeah, it's.
But back in the day, my dad was saying that at a spot out in the Hamptons, Nat Young and someone else showed up.
Nice.
And he said everyone got out of the water and just watched.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They weren't like trying to big dog them or be in the lineup with them. They got out and they.
Yep.
When Lopez paddled out, people watched.
Yeah.
You know, and like Martin Potter actually said this in Surfers, the movie, I think. He's like, you know, kid, or no, it was an article. He's like, kids used to get out of the water. When I was a kid, I used to get out of the water and watch MR surf. And now.
Right.
You know, everyone just wants to drop in, and that was even late 80s.
Right, so it's not a negativity thing about if you new to surfing, this and that, but it's just if there was a message going out, it's just be aware, like, see who the older guy is in the lineup, like,
yeah,
they know where they're sitting, they're catching waves, let me observe what they're doing, maybe, you know, chat with them and not try to jockey.
Yeah.
And things would be fine. You wouldn't have to have localism then. You could go. You could surf any break in the world, and you could go anywhere. Just
hence, one of the things on your topics, wave pools, and why they could be such a force for good.
Well, they are. They are. Go ahead.
I was just gonna say, because my brother just went and surfed the Bristol one.
Sweet.
And he said
England?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He said it was one of the most pleasurable experiences.
Yeah. They are.
He's like, everyone was hooting each other on. No one felt anxious.
It's like a skate park. Yeah. You go to a skate park, and everyone's like, hey, can I get you a beer?
Totally.
Hey, you know, you need my tool. Here's my tool. You need some wax. Like, get some wax. Like, where are you sleeping tonight? You need a place to sleep? It's like, what the fuck? You show up to Sunset Beach, it's like spit fight. Like, mental-wise, people are like, what boat are you on? When are you leaving? When did you get here? They're just like writing everything down.
Wow.
And so, I think the wave park calms all that obsessiveness. There's order to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we would benefit from that. Like, I just keep thinking.
I can't wait.
In the lineup, it's frustrating because you want to wait your turn, but then some people are not going to wait the turn. So then you go and start trying to hold your position until you're out of position. Or it's just frustrating. You're anxious that you're not going to get a wave. And also the waves take, they're few and far between sometimes.
They are,
Yesterday was like that. Really few and far between. And you're just waiting and waiting. And then people would paddle me. And I would just keep going until I was out of position almost. And got dropped in.
You gotta tell them, man. The biggest dog eats first.
Yeah, that's what I said. Where does the big ape sit? Wherever it damn well pleases.
Yeah, wide. I don't even sit at the top anymore. I sit wide, and I just go, and then I just don't understand English, or I have earplugs in, and I just don't even acknowledge the comment or the wordy or whatever. And obviously, I'll have to sit at the top if it's like a if it's a certain spot. But for the most part, you can sit wide. You just go, and then you play dumb. And the truth of it is that the guy or girl that's humping you to the top, they're not going to make the wave anyway.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to go, and everyone's fine anyway. Or I'll catch the wave to the beach. I'll walk it out. By the time then, there's down the beach, and then that's it. But if I go to New York, I get in the at the top of the jetty.
Yeah.
I make like the six of you are sitting at the top of the wave. I make a conscious effort to at least acknowledge you in the face, and I like – obviously paddle outside of you, around you, and if Johnny's the last guy, I'll sit right on the outside of him and sit up on my board just to be like, this is what I'm gonna do.
Yeah.
And I'm just gonna show you that I'm not gonna threaten you. And that's it. And I've done that everywhere in the world, and I've never been in an altercation in my life. I haven't. In Hawaii, Hawaii's so gnarly. Hawaii's not fucking gnarly.
You just don't have to be a dick.
Just don't be a sociopath. Don't be a fucking psycho. And I know that's like raw to say, but that is honestly the truth. Treat people like human beings. Yeah. And people know the difference. They're just like, this beach might be the one where I can pull it over on them. And it's like, no, you probably can.
I actually prefer to surf localized spots.
Yeah, there's an order to it.
It's much easier. Yeah. It's much easier. You guys sit here.
Yeah.
You do your thing.
I'm going down here, and it's fine.
And law and order.
Tons. There's a really crowded, serious wave by me. It's like the county line of Monmouth and Ocean, and I'll go as far as saying that. And that wave, I will make sure that the parking lot, I am parked all the way on the other end. I wait for the boys to get in. I sit. You can sit at get the easy paddle out at the top of the jetty. I go all the way down to the boneyard, paddle out in the middle of the boneyard. I take a bunch of shit on the head, and then I make my way to the top of the lineup, and I say hi to every single guy. And it's painful, and it's weird, and it's awkward, but I do it. And then I just – and I bob there like a kook, even though I'm not, and I play the game. And then by the end, they slowly get out, and then I finally get my wave, and I live to surf another day. And then meanwhile, I see guys that just paddle out at the top because they think they can, or they do because they can, obviously, and they abuse that kind of privilege, you know?
Or that it's expected of, like, that's what you do. You just...
Well, it's like, I have to be Sam Hammer. No, you don't.
No.
There's only one Sam, you know? There's only one Clay Polioni or whomever. And, like, the truth of it is like, those guys are different human beings. And the other truth of it is that some of the average kind of intermediate to moderate surfers don't surf on days where they see those guys do what they really do. It's like, I saw that clip on Instagram. That's seeing that from the beach or seeing that from the water is a way different game, boy. It's like going to good sized green bush and being, I surfed, I went to the Mentawai's this summer and I got to surf with the Basque surfer. He's a handsome, dark haired guy. What's his name?
Capa?
Nope. Yeah. Billabong team rider.
Joan?
No, Joan.
Aritz?
Not Aritz, but very close. It's one more. He got invited to the tow event. He's a
Lucas Champo.
Not Champo. No, he's Brazilian. I think this guy's Basque, and he's beautiful, like handsome, strong, 6'5", 8"
Basque guys, man.
Listen to me.
They exude masculinity. The guy
was going on waves and thinking about going on waves that you wouldn't even want to duck dive. Wouldn't even want to duck dive, and you guys are great surfers. And I'm talking, you're like, oh my god, like this is insane. So like, people don't see that. They're just like, yeah, he rips on a firewire. He can make that drop and get nutted, and I got that on my Simmons. No, you don't. You don't. You don't. You're gonna break the Simmons. You're gonna be paralyzed. Simmons. And these guys are like two stroking into waves. Ballroom at Lido. I watched that go down. And
phenomenal.
There's guys that, from California that flew in for that swell. They look like they saw star. They look like they had been punched. Andrew Doheny was out. He was drowning. The kid Colin Moran, he's a good surfer. He was good. He was hanging tough. Mm-hmm. But like, ballroom was like insane. 40 yards deeper. 20 yards deeper.
The West Coast guys, to be fair, are just not used to the short interval. You know, yeah. The short intervals really fuck people up from West sure. Coast.
Yeah.
Particularly, I've found, where they come here and they're like, what the fuck? I can't get out.
Yeah, it's surging. And I mean, when you're elite, you're elite. But again, like, to be comfortable and, like, one stroking into those waves is pretty serious, you know.